जय राधा माधव कुंड बिहारी यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीर बन सारी यमुना तीर बन सारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन बल्लभ गिरिवर धारी गोपी जन बल्लभ गिरिवर धारी यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीर बन सारी यमुना तीर बन सारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी जय मुस्वा परमंस परिव्राज राचार्य स्थित सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी भगवान की जय अनंतपुर विष्णु की जय रामाचार्य श्री हरिदास ठाकुर की जय प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शुभाचार्य गौर भक्तिमी जय श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गो गोपनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरिवर्धन की जय वृंदावन धाम की जय नवदीप धाम की जाए गंगा माई की जाए जमुना माई की जाए गुरु द्वारका धाम की जाए स्वामी तो भक्तविंद की जाए ऑल ग्लोरी टू जय श्री ऑल ग्लोरी टू जय श्री थैंक यू वेरी मच
विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर शत श्री श्रीमती डिवाइन ग्रेस अभय चरणारविंद भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की ग्रंथराज श्रीमद्भागवतम की वृंददेवी तुलसी महारानी की ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयं मुदीरयेत् नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवत्युत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्टिकी रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम फर्स्ट कैंटो सेकंड चैप्टर टेक्स्ट नंबर 3 यः स्वानुभावं अखिला श्रुति सारम एकम यस्वानुभावमखिलश्रुतिसारमेकम् अध्यात्मा दीपम् अतितितीर्षता तमः अंधम् अध्यात्मदीपम् अतितितीर्षतां तमोऽंधम् संसारिणां करुणयाः पुराणा गुह्यम् संसारिणां करुणयाः पुराण गुह्यम् तं व्यास सूनुम् उपयामि गुरुम् मुनीनां तं व्यास सूनुम् उपयामि गुरुम् मुनीनां यस्वानुभावमखिलश्रुतिसारमेकम् अध्यात्मदीपम् अतितितर्षतां तमोऽन्धम् संसारिणां करुणयाः पुराणगुह्यम् तं व्याससूनुमुपयामि गुरुं मुनीनां यस्वानुभावमखिलश्रुतिसारमेकम् अध्यात्मदीपम् अतितितीर्षतां तमोऽन्धम् संसारिणां करुणयाः पुराणगुह्यम् तं व्याससूनुमुपयामि गुरुं मुनीनां टोन मीनिंग यह ही हु स्व अनुभावम सेल्फ एसिमिलेटेड एक्सपीरियंस्ड अखिल ऑल अराउंड श्रुति दि वेदास सारम क्रीम एकम दि ओनली वन अध्यात्मा ट्रांसेंडेंटल दीपम टॉर्च लाइट अतितितीर्षताम Desiring to overcome, tamah andam, deeply dark material existence, samsarinam, of the materialistic men, karunaya, out of causeless mercy, aha, said, purana, supplement to the Vedas, guhyam, very confidential, tam, unto him. व्याससूनुम् द सन ऑफ व्यासदेवा उपयामि लेट मी ऑफर माय ओबीसेंसेस गुरुम् द स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर मुनीनाम ऑफ द ग्रेट सेजेस ट्रांसलेशन एंड परपोर्ट बाय हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस एसी भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की जाए ट्रांसलेशन Let me offer my respectful obeisances unto him, Shuka, the spiritual master of all sages, the son of Vyasadeva, who, out of his great compassion for those gross materialists who struggle to cross over the darkest regions of material existence, spoke this most confidential supplement to the cream of Vedic knowledge, after having personally assimilated it by experience. Please repeat this translation.
Let me offer
my respectful obeisances unto him, Shuka, the spiritual master of all sages, the son of Vyasadeva, who, out of his great compassion for those gross materialists who struggle to cross over the darkest regions of material existence, spoke this most confidential supplement to the cream of Vedic knowledge, after having personally assimilated it by experience. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. In this prayer, Srila Suta Goswami practically summarizes the complete introduction of Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam is the natural supplementary commentary on the Vedanta Sutras. The Vedanta Sutras or the Brahma Sutras were compiled by Vyasadeva with a view to presenting just the cream of Vedic knowledge. Srimad Bhagavatam is the natural commentary on this cream. Srila Shukadeva Goswami was a thoroughly realized master of the Vedanta Sutra, and consequently he also personally realized the commentary Srimad Bhagavatam. And just to show his boundless mercy upon bewildered materialistic men who want to cross completely over nescience, he recited for the first time this confidential knowledge. There is no point in arguing that a materialistic man can be happy. No materialistic creature, be he the great Brahma or an insignificant ant, can be happy. Everyone tries to make a permanent plan for happiness, but everyone is baffled by the laws of material nature. Therefore, the materialistic world is called the darkest region of God's creation. Yet, the unhappy materialists can get out of it simply by desiring to get out. Unfortunately, they are so foolish that they do not want to escape. Therefore, they are compared to the camel who relishes thorny twigs because he likes the taste of the twigs mixed with blood. He does not realize that it is his own blood and that his tongue is being cut by the thorns. Similarly, to the materialist, his own blood is as sweet as honey, and although he is always harassed by his own material creations, he does not wish to escape. Such materialists are called karmis. Out of hundreds of thousands of karmis, only a few may feel tired of material engagement and desire to get out of the labyrinth. Such intelligent persons are called jnanis. The Vedanta Sutra is directed to such jnanis. But Srila Vyasadeva, being the incarnation of the Supreme Lord, could foresee the misuse of the Vedanta Sutra by unscrupulous men, and therefore he personally supplemented the Vedanta Sutra with the Bhagavata Purana. It is clearly said that this Bhagavatam is the original commentary on the Brahma Sutras. Srila Vyasadeva also instructed the Bhagavatam to his own son, Srila Shukadeva Goswami, who was already at the liberated stage of transcendence. Srila Shukadeva realized it personally and then explained it. By the mercy of Srila Shukadeva, the Bhagavata Vedanta Sutra is available for all those sincere souls who want to get out of material existence. Srimad Bhagavatam is the one unrivaled commentary on Vedanta Sutra. Sripada Shankaracharya intentionally did not touch it because he knew that the natural commentary would be difficult for him to surpass. He wrote his Shariraka Bhashya, and his so-called followers deprecated the Bhagavatam as some new presentation. One should not be misled by such propaganda directed against the Bhagavatam by the Mayavada school. From this introductory shloka, the beginning student should know that Srimad Bhagavatam is the only transcendental literature meant for those who are Paramahamsas and completely freed from the material disease called malice. The Mayavadis are envious of the personality of Godhead, despite Sripad Shankaracharya's admission that Narayana, the personality of Godhead, is above the material creation. The envious Mayavadi cannot have access to the Bhagavatam, but those who are really anxious to get out of this material existence may take shelter of this Bhagavatam because it is uttered by the liberated Srila Shukadeva Goswami. इट इज़ द ट्रांसेंडेंटल टॉर्च लाइट बाई विच वन कैन सी परफेक्टली द ट्रांसेंडेंटल एब्सोल्यूट ट्रूथ रियलाइज एज ब्रह्मन परमात्मा एंड भगवान दस सेंट्स द भक्तिवेदांत परपट।
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, second chapter, text number 3, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on May 27th, 1974, in Rome, Italy.
Jasanubhavam akhilasutisharamekam adhyatadivam adhichitir sadangatamodam संसारिणां करुणयाः पुराणगृह्यं सङ्गव्यासशूनं मुतजामि गुरुं मणिन स सूतपुरुषाणि आपणे रेस्पेक्ट टू द स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर सुखदेव गोस्वामी व्हेन वी ऑफर रेस्पेक्ट टू द स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर एंड एनी मास्टर वी ग्लोरीफाई हिज ट्रांसेंडेंटल क्वालिटी That is glorification. Just like we offer respect to Krishna, glorifying. So, this is a very important process. To glorify the spiritual master by his activities, what he is actually doing. That is glorification. So what Sukadeva Goswami did, Sanubhava. He first of all heard from his father, Vyasadeva, Bhagavad Srimad Bhagavatam, and realized it. Not a professor in Bhagavad reciter. It's like in India now, there are a class of men, especially in Vrindavan, the Gosai. They make a business. Therefore, there are many, many very artistic Bhagavad reciters, but they could not turn even one man to Krishna consciousness because they are not self-realized, sanubhava. And of course, we have tried our best. So in few years, there are so many Krishna conscious persons. No. This is the secret. Unless one is sanubhava, self-realized, life is bhava, he cannot please God. That will not be effective. Gramophone will not help. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu secretary, Sarup Damodar, recommended Bhagavata Parogya Bhagavata Sthana. That if you want to read Srimad Bhagavatam, you must approach a person who is live, living Bhagavata. Bhagavata Parogya Bhagavata Sthana. Otherwise, there is no Krishna, Bhagavata realized. So, Sukadeva Goswami learned from his father and Vyasadeva, Mahabhagavata, and he realized. Sanubhavam. What is this book? Akhila Shruti Saramekam. Akhila means all, universe. There are many scriptures, many religious scriptures, especially the Vedas. Shruti means Veda. Shruti is learned by hearing. Not by reading. You can understand basic principle even though you are not illiterate, provided you hear them orally said. God has given you the ear, and if you try to hear submissively to receive something, then it will. This is the Brahman realization when he met Krishna. So he said this verse, Jnani Prayasam Udapasam Namanta Eva Namanta Eva Sarvakuritanga Bhavadiya Vata. People who are endeavoring to understand the absolute truth by the dint of his puffed up knowledge, they will never be. Jnani Prayasam. One has to give up this illegitimate attempt to understand the absolute truth by his personal knowledge. That is not. Krishna is not so cheap thing that by exercising your brain you can manufacture a way to understand Krishna. Krishna says, Naham prakasa sarvasya yoga maya samaha. I am not exposed to everyone. I am covered by yoga maya. People will not be able to understand me. So many jnani yogis, karmis, they cannot understand. No. Then Krishna says, bhaktya bhava vijanati, javan jaschami. Only through devotional service means submission. Surrender. First of all, surrender. Sarvadharman parityajya mamekam saranam. You cannot understand me by your so-called karma, jnana, yoga, jnana. No. It is not possible. Bhaktyama vijnana. Bhakta means to surrender. So, here it is sutisarame. And this Bhagavata is the Shruti Sharam, just like cream. You churn the milk, 2 months of milk, you get, say, 5 kg of butter. The Sharam, essence. If you simply try to see where is the essence, you have to churn it. Then milk there is, it can be, you may possess lots of milk. But from the milk you have to take the cream. That is intelligence. This Srimad Bhagavatam is the cream of Vedic. Therefore it is said that Nigama Kalpataru Galidam Phalamidam. Nigama means Vedas, and Kalpaturu, Veda is just like desert tree. Desert tree means what you want, you can have it from Vedic knowledge. Just like in India, the Ayurveda, Ayurveda means this is material thing, but still it is in the Veda, Rig Veda, military science. There are so many Veda. Veda means knowledge. So, the Vedic knowledge is so perfect that anything you want, material or spiritual, you get the knowledge perfect. That is Vedic. Veda is not ordinary thing. And it is learned by hearing. Tadvijnanartham sa gurumeva avigachet srotriyam brahmanishtam. Vedic knowledge, formerly there was no need of books. Nowadays, at the present moment, our memory is not so sharp due to Kali Yuga. Therefore, Vyasadeva wrote in books, in words, because he foresaw that the people in this age, they are a little bit dull-headed, rascals. Therefore, if they get this knowledge recorded in writing, they may be able to derive some. Otherwise, formerly, Vedic knowledge was never book reading. No. Shruti. Shruti means hearing. This disciple is so powerful that once he hears from the spiritual master, his memory is recorded immediately. That memory, therefore, Brahmacharya, record. If you remain brahmachari, then your brain will be so nice that as soon as you hear something, it will be memorized. This is the benefit of brahmachari. And if the students are allowed to be sexually indulgent, then where is the brain? This is very scientific, to remain brahmachari. To understand from the Guru by simply by hearing. Once here. There was a case, of course, Englishman chastised another Indian by calling him so many ill names, damn rascal, fool, like that. So, he complained in the court that this man has insulted me. So, where is the witness? So, the witness, the appellant said, there was a Brahmin who was witness. He was taking bath in the Ganges. So, he was summoned. The Brahmin was so sharp in memory, he exactly said, just like gramophone record, tape record, whatever he said. He said, I do not know what is the meaning of this, but these words were said. So, people are so sharp in memory, that is Brahmin. Once he heard from the spiritual master is Sotriya, he has also nicely heard from the spiritual master. Therefore, Vedic knowledge, factually, it is easy simply by hearing. There is no necessity of becoming literate. Illiterate doesn't matter. Because it is, after all, received through the oral listening. That which is called Shruti. And Shruti Sarami comes. And of all the basic literature, Srimad Bhagavatam is the essence. See, back there, first of all, describe Vedas in four Vedas and describes further in Upanishad, further in Puranas. The Puranas, some of the rascals say the Puranas are not written by Vyasadeva. They are rascals. Puranas are also explained further, supplemented. Purana means which completes. Another Purana means the very old, historical. So, Puranas, they are mentioned, the basic instruction through the history. Just like basic instruction, Mahabharata. Mahabharata is history. But the whole basic literature is there, ideal. King, how kingdom, politics, practically it is politics, but it is based on Vedic literature. And the Bhagavad Gita is introduced in the Mahabharata. So, the Srimad Bhagavatam is the essence of all Vedic literature. This is the only one. You cannot present another. Ekam. If God is one, similarly, to understand Him, there is only one literature, that is Srimad Bhagavatam. Bhagavad Gita is the preliminary study of Srimad Bhagavatam. Suti Saram Ekam. Suti Saram Adhyatma Deepam. Adhyatma Deepam means, just like Atma, the soul, is within this body. But due to our darkness, knowledge, insufficient knowledge, we cannot understand Atma, Paramatma. We cannot understand. So, in the darkness, as we require a torch light, similarly, Srimad Bhagavatam is just like the torch light. You can see Atma and Paramatma. Atma, Deepam. Deepam means light, lamp. The white is required. Atititir satam. just like light is required by a person who wants to go through the light, go through the darkness, but go to the light. Suppose here is light and there is tunnel, and in the tunnel you require some light to go to the other part of the light. Similarly, this world, this material world, is full of darkness. That is the difference between material world and spiritual world. Material world means darkness, wherein you cannot understand what is God, what you are. That is material world. They are very busy in this material world, but they do not know where they are going. Actually, they are darkness. Material world is darkness. Their so-called scholars and teachers, they are also in the darkness, and they are leading other people in the darkness. Because it is darkness, therefore we require sunshine, moonshine, and this electricity. As soon as it is covered, the sun is covered, you can experience it is darkness. At night, it is darkness. Actually, it is darkness. But by the grace of Krishna, He has arranged the light. But there is another world where there is no need of na tatra vasate surya na sasanka na pavaka. There is another world where there is no need of these things, lighting agent, either sunshine or moonshine. But God is so kind that in each and every universe it is full of darkness. Now you see how brilliant sun is there. This is His kindness. Jasa prabha prabhavatu jagadanya koti. Yakshakshuresa savita sakalam grahana. Therefore the sun is described as the eye of all the planets. Because we have got very nice good planet, very nice city, Rome, and London or America, this or that, that's all nice. But as soon as it is dark, you cannot see anything. The mercy of sunshine, Krishna's mercy is there, therefore you can see. You can enjoy. Therefore sun is the sky. Jamsak Suresa Savita, Savita means sun. Is Chakshu. Savita is actually the eyes. Yachaksu resa savita sagalagrahana. Without sunshine you cannot see. In any part of the universe, in any planet, actually the sun is supposed to be the eye. One eye is the sun, another eye of the absolute, Virata Rupa. So when He sees, then you can see. Without His seeing, you cannot see. We are very much proud. Can you show me? What can you see? That's it. Unless God sees, you cannot see. Why you are so much proud of saying, we have not seen, we have not seen? What you can see? They're so rascal, they have these teeny eyes, they're proud of, they can see God. They can see this thing, they can see. First of all, understand what you can see without seeing by the God. God sees by the sun. Then you can see. Your seeing power is so dependent, and you are so much proud that you can see. You just see how much the whole world is full of rascals. Do they not say, we have not seen God? And what you can see? You cannot see even yourself, and what you will see, God? You are seeing your father and mother, and when they die, you are crying, oh, my father has gone. Where he has gone? He is lying here. Why do you say, my father has gone? No, he is gone. What do you mean by gone? See, father, you have always seen the body of the father, that is lying here. What do you say? That means you have never seen your father. You have never seen your brother. So this is our position. We cannot see. He still, you are proud. Can you show me God? He does not think his incapability, that I cannot see him. Our daily necessities of life without this sunlight. Therefore, here it is said, Adhyatma Deepam. It is the light. If you want to see God, then you have to see through this light. And for whom this seeing is necessary? It is not necessary for the ordinary rascals. It is necessary, Atititiri Satanatam Ondham, one who is sober to think that why we are put into the darkness. We require light, find that unless God gives us the light, sunlight, we are always in night. You cannot see. Tam Ondham. So those who are intelligent, that why shall I remain in this darkness? If there is light, just like in daytime, if there is a dark room, we are staying. And if you hear that why I shall stay in this darkness, there is light, there is sunlight outside, immediately we will be busy. Let me go to the light, why shall I remain in this dark room? Similarly, the sober man, intelligent man, he will think that I am put into this material world which is full of darkness. Is there any light? Where can I go? That is intelligence. Delhi is in the northern part of the hemisphere. 6 months, no light. So, it is intelligence. That why you are discovering so many electricity light? Because you want light. So, therefore, intelligent person should be that this material world is by nature dark, whether there is another nature where there is only light. Therefore, it is said, Otititir Satana Tamondham. This Srimad Bhagavatam is required for such intelligent person who wants to go out of this darkness to light. The Vedic information is that tamasi ma jyotirgama, don't remain in the dark, just go out to the light, jyotirgama. Jyotir means light. Vedic injunction is that don't remain in the darkness, go to the light. So when one becomes inquisitive, how to go to the light, for him this Srimad Bhagavatam. That what he said, the Otititiri Satam. Titiri Satam means to surpass, to overcome. Otititiri Satam, desiring to overcome. Otititiri Satam, Tam Ondham, this darkness, the position darkness. Who are in the darkness? Why these people are in the dark? Saṅsārinām, they are undergoing the punishment because they have forgotten Krishna, they have defied the supremacy of Krishna. They are put into the darkness. Just like one who defies the laws of the government, they are put into the jail, outlaws. Similarly, Krishna Bhuliyaji Bhagavan, these rascals who have forgotten Krishna, God, to serve Him, and wants to remain independent without serving, they are made servant of the prison house, Maya. Just like the criminal. We don't care for government law. We can do anything. All life, come on here. Go, fly. Remain here. This is our position. Simply defying, I don't care for God. You may not care, but Maya is there. He'll give you kick and put you in there. You'll learn how to care. You'll learn how to care. This is the position. These rascals, they have become godless and suffering day and night.
थ्री फोर मिजरीज आध्यात्मिक आदि दैविक आदि भौतिक स्थिति दे आर नॉट कमिंग टू दिस सेंटर सो ब्लड सो डल दैट वी आर दिस इज इंटेलिजेंट व्हेन वन कम्स टू दिस अंडरस्टैंडिंग that I don't want all these sufferings, why they are forced upon me, then he can become elected. Just in the jail, nobody wants to, I would say, what is called? Breaking stone. He doesn't want, but there is jail superintendent's order, he must break so much. And there is stick, if you don't break, so it is going on. Maya is kicking, all is. Imagine, patitekramanani kunai karmani. He wanted to eat anything and everything, all that. You take this body, hop hop, and eat soon, that's all. This is Maya, prakriti. He has given you a body, you have to suffer according to the body. Karanam gunasangasya, sadasam janma junish. Why there are different types of bodies? Different types of enjoyment. Everyone is in the material world. Why one has become hawk, one has become dog, and one has become very rich man and demigod, very bad. Why? Who is making arrangement? Who wants to become cat and dog? Who does not want to become king? But why this is arrangement? Who is doing this? This rascal cannot understand. Therefore, to cover all this ignorance, they do not believe in the nature. But where from these varieties of life are coming? They have no brain. The so-called scientists, so-called all bogus theory. Pakita kramanani, munai karmani. As you desire, you will give this chance by prakriti. Prakita kramanani, munai karmani. Ahankara vimura atma katta ahamiti vandate. He is thinking that I am independent. Vimura. Rascal. Katta, it's not katta. When there is death, you do not like to die. Why there is death? Why you are forced to die? What is your scientist will say? Oh, this is natural. But you cannot fight. You do not want to die. But death is forced, and you do not, even though you do not like, you say, hey, it is natural. So you cannot explain why death is forced there. Why birth is so forced there. Janma mittu jarabhyadhi. You do not want to become old man. Why you are forced to become old man? You do not want to have disease. Why you are forced to accept disease? They have no sense. They're so dull headed. They do not want any solution. But there is solution. Therefore it is called samsarina. They are dull headed, rascal. They are undergoing the nature's process from one life to another, all miserable condition. To get out of this miserable condition, Sukadev says, here he says, Kurunaya aha. Kurunaya means out of compassion. People are suffering. This is Vaishnava. Vaishnava takes so much trouble to speak to the rascals and dulls about God consciousness. Why? Out of compassion. They are very compassionate. So many people are suffering for want of knowledge. Let me try to give them. Kurunaya. This is Vaishnava's qualification. He is very kind. Titik sava karunika. Titik sava karunika. It's like Lord Jesus Christ. He was being crucified. Still, he was saying, my father, they do not know what that is. Is it not? Is so much compassionate that these rascals do not know what they are doing, rascals. Still, I request you to forgive them. This is Vaishnava. Personally, he is suffering, but he is still compassionate. There was an article recently that Jesus Christ, although he was crucified, he did not die. Yes. He went to Kashmir, some historical references there. So, actually, when he was representative of God, Son of God, how this rascal could kill him? It was a soul. Anyway, so the devotee, they are so compassionate, the titiksava, they suffer all kinds of odds in this material world. Still, they try to give information. There is God, there is kingdom of God, you are suffering here, please do this so that you can again come back to home. But this is the question. Karunaya, out of compassion. Karunaya ha purana guhyam. Purana, there are 18 types of puranas. Out of that, Bhagavata is also purana. This purana is very confidential. This is not ordinary. It is called spotless. Spotless purana. Because in this purana, in this history, or in this supplementary of Vedic knowledge, there is only a description of devotional service. Dharma prujita, this dharma, this kind religious, the Bhagavad religion, is so perfect that all kinds of cheating types of religion is kicked out from dharma prujita. They are not accepted. All cheating types of religion. There are so many religions. There is not perfect knowledge. In the disobey, they cannot without disobey. Because it cannot train people to the perfection. They remain defective always. Big priests, big cardinals, they are what they are doing. They simply disobey. Christ says, thou shalt not kill, so simply eating meat. That's all. No intoxicants, they are taking meat. They cannot be trained. Hindu so-called priests, they are not trained. They cannot take it up. Therefore, Bhagavad principle is so nice that little training, sarpamapiyasya dharmasya trayati mahatuva. Little training, even the most fallen can be elevated to the highest position. This is Bhagavad. Perfect. Purana guhyam. So, who did it? Sukadeva Goswami, first of all, explained. Srimad Bhagavatam before Parikshit Maharaj. That is the beginning of Bhagavad teaching. This is Krishna consciousness.